If you want to connect your external hard drive to iPhone to transfer files between devices, for that you need this Lightning to OTG plus USB-C port. It's for auxiliary power supply. Then second, you need this USB-C to HDMI adapter, and that's it. For this product, I will give the link, Amazon link, in the description. If you want, you can buy there. It's like $3 or something. It's like $5 totally within $10. And you are ready to move the files from iPhone to hard drive. At last, you just need an adapter or charger to power the external hard drive. So if you have this 80 watts mobile fast charging adapter, you can use that. Or you can use your iPad adapter or your MacBook or laptop adapter. You can also use this. Or if you doesn't have these power adapters, you can use your power banks. Okay, if you doesn't have your power bank, you can use your laptop or MacBook USB port. So still you doesn't have Mac or laptop, you can use your Apple charger. So this is the iPhone 11 charger. You can use this charger also, or you can literally use Samsung charger or any other brand charger. I will show you how. So you don't need this Apple adapter or expensive USB hub. You don't need that, because your external hard drive only needs a 5 volt DC power supply and 900 milliamps. Here you can see the data. It's the adapter. You don't need the USB hub. You just need an adapter which delivers 5 volt and 1000 milliamps. So this is 5 volt and 1000 milliamps adapter, the basic one. It works fine. I will show you. First, take your USB-C to HDMI adapter and connect this USB-C end to your 2-in-1 OTG, I mean Lightning OTG. Connect this on the auxiliary support, this side one, just like that. Just connect the USB-C to USB-C socket. Then take your external hard drive and connect this USB end to this USB end, just like that. Then I'm going to use this iPhone 11 adapter, this small one. I just connect the USB A cable to this adapter end, and I just plug it on the power socket. Just like that. You can see. Then connect this small end on this type C port. Here you can see the charging symbol, this small one. Then if you see the light on the hard disk, if it continuously starts illuminating, means your hard disk works fine. There is no issue. In case if the light comes and goes off, you need to disconnect your iPhone and hard disk and restart your iPhone. Then if you have another adapter or charger, you can try with that. If you don't have, just restart and again try to connect. Hopefully it works. For now it works fine. Now just take your iPhone. Make sure you unlock the screen. And your iPhone must have at least 60% battery. Then just open files. Then connect this Lightning end to your charging port, just like that. Then boom, it comes. Yeah, for me it's my password, which is my 2 TB external hard disk WD. So first thing you need to do is you need to check your hard disk was formatted to NTFS or not. If your iPhone iOS version was 18 or above, you can do that on iPhone. If you are below iOS 18, you need to watch this video. For now, I'm on iOS 17 because for video purpose, I don't want to update to iOS 18, but I will show you in my iPad exactly same process. So after you see your hard drive, just long press over that and click get info. Then here you can see format. It shows XFAT. If it shows NTFS, you need to format your hard drive to XFAT or any other Apple file system. Then only you can transfer files between hard drive to iPhone, iPhone to hard drive. So you just need to again long press the hard drive and click erase. And here you can choose any of this file format. I leave it for default exFAT. Then click erase, confirm that. Here you can see it's formatted. It's tick mark. That's it. Okay, let's transfer the files. For now, I want to transfer from Photos app to my hard drive. I just came here and select some photos and videos and click share and save to files, back, and choose my hard drive and just click here to create a new folder and just type as gallery, click done and just click save. So it's transferring now. The speed was amazing actually. It's like when we connect your iPhone to PC, like that speed. It's done. Now, if you want to transfer from Files app to hard drive, open the file you have. I just open this video and select this and click move and back. Choose that and I just came here and just copy. Here you can see the videos are transferring. It's done. If you want to transfer photos and videos from your hard drive to your iPhone, just open My Passport and just open this and just click select and select like this and click move. Just back on my iPhone and just open a new folder. I just put it as XDD, done. Just click copy. Here you can see it's transferring from hard drive to my iPhone. Yeah, it's done. So this is the thing. Okay, after you done the transferring process, just minimize this and close the recent completely and disconnect the cable first. And if you want more safety, turn off your iPhone and disconnect this. And then disconnect the power to the hard drive. That's it, it's done. And the important thing is, if you connect any adapter, if it doesn't work, so you need to disconnect that and restart your iPhone. And then connect with the same adapter, or if you have different adapter, you can also try with that adapter. So this is the thing, you need to make sure restart after unsuccessful attempt. So that's the thing I want to remind you. Yeah, that's it. You successfully transfer files from iPhone to hard drive, hard drive to iPhone. It works fine for huge amount of files too. And if you want to know more videos about iPhone, watch these videos.